But it's the same .45?
No, it's a full-time position.
See, that's what I'm not clear with.
As an administrative position, we pay a lot for that particular position. I don't believe it needs to be an administrative position.
Then can I request that a narrative be provided about the things that you suggested, so for further clarification? And I prefer to, with the consent of the board, move to table this until we can have that information and a clearer, more informed discussion. I will move to table this discussion to the next board meeting.
And a motion to table discussion until the next meeting where we can have more narrative. Mr. Percy?
I want to second that, but before I do, I'd like to offer any other board members, if they have questions, to put them out now before we table this.
Well, you can second the table motion, and then we can have that discussion if there's other comments that need to be made. So we got a motion and a second by Mr. Percy. Is there any other comments, Ms. Fisher?
In that narrative, I would just like some more specifics on exactly what the subject leaders are hoping for them to achieve.
Ms. Goldish?
And in addition, which are the new positions? I heard the Human Resources Executive Secretary is a new position, the seat evaluator is a new position. What are the other positions? And I'm looking at the Friday notes that say the curriculum coordinator positions for fine arts and world languages have been eliminated, and I see a ELASSELL curriculum coordinator. What does that stand for?
English Language Arts, English as a Second Language, and Social Studies. That's a current position.
And the curriculum coordinator position for the world languages is eliminated.
That's a half-time position.
Since we just hired a new principal, are any of the persons in the positions being eliminated certified to be a principal?
They're all certified to be principals, that's correct.
Then their union, do they have bumping rights?
They certainly do.
Is there a possibility that any of them would ask for bump on the principal?
There are enough positions for everybody.
But it is in the realm of possibilities that someone, if they're certified to be a principal, may choose
to. If we eliminated more positions than I've suggested, yes, but there are enough positions for everybody.
Thank you.
Any further comments? I have a motion to table and a second. I'm going to call for a show of hands for all in favor. And she hands. Item 7.4, Board of Education Finance Committee report.
Through the chair, call your attention to the year-to-date budget report that was distributed before tonight's meeting. We have somewhat of a perfect budget storm brewing, a lean baseline operating budget, combined with unprecedented increases in our magnet school tuition and special education costs, as well as an uncertainty of state funding for special education costs, have contributed to our current financial position. Daily, we continue to analyze our budget, control costs, and make reasonable projections to the end of our fiscal year. In the area of those reasonable projections, I'd like to call your attention to, very briefly, Mr. Chairman, to certain line items that we have increased encumbrances for based upon operational need. We'll start with 51117 coaching. We've fully encumbered that line item based upon the projected need for the rest of the fiscal year. 51124 hourly non-affiliated, we encumbered an additional $22,948. 51137 in lieu of medical insurance, fully encumbered that line item based upon projected usage for the remainder of the fiscal year. 51152 substitute teachers, fully encumbered the remaining balance of $108,015 in that line item. And I'd like to add for that, again, this is substitute teachers for covering for essential work that needs to be done in the school district. We've really cut back as part of our hard freeze at looking at travel, as well as professional development outside of the school district. Temporary salaries, 51159, an additional encumbrance of $5,500 was made in that line item. Moving on to the second page, we fully encumbered the remainder of our payroll taxes. That's 52179 Medicare, 52220 Social Security, in the amount of $251,936. We de-encumbered, so we put back into available fund balance $10,000 based upon our projected usage for the remainder of the fiscal year for unemployment compensation, 52500. Moving down towards the bottom half of the page, under utility services sewer use, we fully encumbered the remaining available balance of $21,528 based on projected use for the remainder of the year. Same goes for rental of equipment and vehicles. We have payments totaling $9,947 for Kubota's. And our fire safety system repairs, line item 54816, in the amount of $14,570 was encumbered. Moving on to the third page, under line item 55920, field and athletic trips, we've encumbered $15,880. Employee travel, encumbered $18,871, zeroing out that line item. We have a new line item to draw your attention to, and that's 55816. In the interest of transparency of showing our actual costs related to special education services, we've added the magnet school tuition special education line item, again, 55816. And that's showing new expenditures in this budget of $217,993. Moving on to the last page of the year-to-date report, under section 56900, other supplies and materials based upon projected need for the remainder of the fiscal year across the district. For special ed services, we've uncovered $18,000. 57720, computer software, an encumbrance of $25,719 for our software license fees. And finally, 57854, non-instructional equipment, an encumbrance of $19,971, completely encumbering the remaining balance based upon projected need for the remainder of the fiscal year. All in total, this gives our grand total projected fund balance for the remainder of the fiscal year at -$1,531,277. As far as what revenues we have direct control over, we're projecting conservatively at a 65% reimbursement rate from the State Department of Education for our special education reimbursement level. That comes out at about $820,212. So we're looking at a projected deficit of about $711,000 for the current fiscal year. Of note, we are bringing in additional revenues to the town to the tune of about $250,000 in Medicaid reimbursement. That's fairly new money that we haven't tapped into at that level before. And our special education, including VOAG tuition, is around $246,000 projected revenue that goes to the town general fund for a total of $496,000 in projected revenues to the town general fund.
Thank you, Mr. Carr. Does anybody have any questions for Mr. Carr? Ms. Arnold.
How much had the town projected in that Medicaid account?
$40,000 through Mr. Chair.
And you're thinking that we'll see $250,000.
Through you, Mr. Chair, that's our current projection, yes.
Any other questions? Seeing none, thank you, Mr. Carr, for that report. Item 8.0. Review the calendar. Does anybody have any changes for the calendar? No, we're going to be discussing the future here, the calendar for this year, based on snow days. We will be seeing that in the next month. Yeah.
Next meeting.
To talk about where we're at, just for the food for thought for everybody. I did hear from project graduation, they are concerned because they've already got the date that they're looking for project graduation. So you may hear something from those folks as well. And something to think about. Okay, moving on to item 9.0. This is the opportunity for questions from the press. I see you patches here. Any questions?
Dean, I didn't get the vote on the $1,000 gift. I couldn't see all the hands. Is it possible to read that out of the record?
Yeah. Ms. Buchanan, if you could read that. That was
item 7.2.
Mrs. Bush made the motion. It was seconded by Mr. Nicholson, and we have Mr. Percy and Ms. Goldich and Mr. Buttar opposed.
And Mrs.
And Mrs. Ms. Sarn.
Thank you.
And Mr. Kennedy, out in the back, any questions from the general choir?
I'm all set.
Thank you. I don't believe there's any other press. Motion, final motion?
Move to adjourn.
I have a motion to adjourn. I have a motion to adjourn and a second by Mr. Buttar. And this is a non-debatable motion. I'll ask for a vote. All in favor? We are adjourned.